Carol Burnett, this is a sad story, but I do really, I'm inspired by her advocacy for her family. So she is seeking guardianship of her 14-year-old grandson. The 87-year-old comedian is asking the court that she and her husband become temporary guardians of their grandson, Dylan. Carol says her daughter, Erin Hamilton, has struggled with substance abuse and addiction since Dylan was born and has been in and out of rehab 8 times over the past 19 years. Carol's other daughter, Carrie Hamilton, also struggled with drug addiction as a teen. She died from complications due to lung cancer in 2002. Wow. Al, what do you make of her wanting to be the legal guardian at her age, the grandmother, and considering this history of addiction within her own family?
Well, you know, Sam, anytime we do a story about a celebrity, we'll get comments like, oh, you know, they're rich, they'll figure it out. I think this story is one that we won't get those comments because it hits so close to home for so many people. The plague that opioids have been on this country have wiped out really almost, you know, a large population of young parents. Who's up next? The grandparents. We have a lot of people in their early, mid 60s, early 70s raising toddlers, Sam. So this is unfortunately not that uncommon, and we need to do something about the opioid problem, but in the same time, figuring
alcoholism,
out something.
Yes. Addiction in general.
Figuring out a way to get these people help as well,
yeah.
Because I couldn't imagine. I'm tired now at 43. I don't
right.
know how people do it.
I don't know how they would either, Jeff. I mean, you have two little ones. I have two little ones. I can't imagine, to Al's point, being twice my age and having to do that. But you know, credit to her.
I mean, this is a last resort, right, Sam? Nobody wants this. I'm sure Carol Burnett doesn't even want this. But if people didn't love her enough already, they're going to love her even more. At 87 years old, trying to be a mother, I'm 42, my wife's 8 years younger than me. We can't keep up with our kids, you know? So at 87, it's a lot tougher road. But Sam, I want to throw it back into your court because this is kind of your expertise area, having worked with Dr. Drew in addiction on all those years.
Yeah, I think, you know, listen, addiction does not discriminate. So, you know, Al mentioned that, you know, we in the past and maybe even now we'll get comments saying, oh, you know, she can afford to send her to rehab again. And there seems to be some sort of leniency when it comes to people of wealth or celebrities when they also succumb to addiction. Well, again, it doesn't discriminate. And the only advice I would give is Al-Anon. Al-Anon is something that I, you know, went to for years. So if you have addiction in your family, if you can go to Al-Anon, you also will practice the 12 steps and you will also learn how to self-govern and not empower, or I should say rather, not empower, but
enable
that person. It's a lifesaver. So that's the only thing that I could, the only advice I
could. And really quickly, tell everybody what Al-Anon is.
So Al-Anon is a support group, just like the 12 steps with AA, but it's for people that are codependent and they are also surrounded by addiction. So again, to any of our viewers out there, it is also a lifesaver for you.